They've been waiting all year for this moment. They'll never forget this night.
You talk about game-breaking plays. There it was. Into the wind and rain.
He's got it!
A great night for high school football. All week, they've been getting revved up for this neighborhood showdown. Hart used to be the top dog, but the last 3 years, Valencia has ruled the Foothill League. It's the Ford CIF Southern Section High School Football Game of the Week coming at you from College of the Canyons. It's Valencia and Hart. We take a look at the CIF Northern Division Top 10. Valencia, after three straight trips to the semifinals, they are in the fourth slot. Hart, with all those CIF championships from the past, they are back, and they are in the eighth position.
Welcome, everybody. I'm Chris McGee, along with my broadcast partner, Mr. John Jackson, out of USC. Now, JJ, these kids have all grown up together. This game is important on so many levels.
They know each other very well, Gator. The reason why, the schools are only 5 miles apart. But this game is all about positioning in the Foothill League. Valencia is undefeated. They're 2-0, so they're on top. Hart got upset last week by Saugus, so they're 1-1. They can ill afford a second loss. It could put them in jeopardy of making the playoffs.
JJ, we've been covering Hart so many times, so many great teams over the years, always known for their offense, and they have a couple of special receivers that we're going to talk about in a moment. Let's start with their running game and Dylan Edwards.
Well, Dylan Edwards is what makes this Hart offense go, and if they had their choice, they would run him continuously tonight. He had 4 games over 100 yards rushing, so he is very important to this offense. But the fact that they're going against a tough Valencia defense is going to make the rush yards tough, so he's going to need a supporting cast. And in that supporting cast, he has two outstanding receivers on the outside. Tim White, the fastest player on this Hart team, as well as Trent Irwin, only a freshman and the best freshman in the entire state of California. Both these playmakers on the outside have to get it done for Hart if they're going to score points and if they're going to become victorious against Valencia.
Now, JJ, the Valencia offense has come alive the last 2 weeks, putting up 65 points. A lot of it is because their running game has come together. Jake Soley, 240 yards over the last 2 weeks.
Well, the reason that Valencia has been so effective is because Soley has really set the pace. He's really the heart and soul of this offense, and he will pound the rock continuously tonight. They want to control the line of scrimmage. They think they're better up front. Soley is the engine that makes this machine run. He has to have a big night. But he also has a supporting cast, and that supporting cast is Billy Shipman, two-way player on the offensive and defensive line. Shipman will open holes for Soley as well as lead a very stout defense. This is a great defensive line that Valencia has. We think that this is one of the best defensive lines that we have seen the entire year.
We love rivalry games, and we're going to have a great one tonight for you from College of the Canyons. It is Valencia and Hart. Opening kickoff is next.
Ford CIF Southern Section Game of the Week is presented by your Southern California Ford dealers. Visit us today and trade up to Ford. By Jack in the Box. Right now at Jack in the Box, get the new Outlaw Burger or Spicy Chicken Sandwich at participating restaurants. And by Farmer John. Taste the local flavor.
Welcome, everybody, from College of the Canyons. It's a rivalry game in the Foothill League, as Valencia will be taking on Hart in the Ford CIF Southern Section Game of the Week. That's the head man in charge for Valencia in his seventh season, Coach Larry Muir. What a fantastic job he has done at Valencia. 55 wins, 69% winning percentage, 3 straight trips to the semifinals. And a legend on the other side in these parts, 6 CIF titles in his 23rd season. Mike Harrington, 237 victories. Let's check in with the third member of our broadcast team, Courtney Jones.
Hey, Chris. Tonight is not the first time these two schools are competing against each other this week. On Wednesday, a pep rally challenged Valencia High and Hart High to a canned food drive competition. Spirit of Giving pep rally, and that was at Power Ford of Santa Clarita, brought out both schools' dance teams. They had the cheerleaders competing, drum lines, and everybody just to build up anticipation for tonight's game. free food. I mean, the atmosphere was incredible. Farmer John's hot dogs given out, raffle tickets. I mean, in the end, Valencia won the canned food drive competition and will be recognized on our air this season. Fans absolutely loved it, and it was so powerful to see the community work together for a good cause, guys.
Thank you, Courtney. JJ, you and I mentioned at the top of the show the neighborhood showdown. These guys grow up together. They know each other, and it's an important ball game as we look at your keys to the game.
Well, the neighborhood wanted to work together, but it was still important that Valencia won. Let's take a look at the keys for Valencia. They have to pound the ground. They want to run the football solely as a man that they want to run the rock. Hart, they have to wing it with Wingenroth, and that means that they need big plays. Although Wingenroth is more of an athletic running type of quarterback, he's going to have to make some big plays in the passing game tonight because of the style of defense Valencia plays. And finally, you have to play and earn your own style points. This game will be all about style. Valencia needs big plays, explosive plays. Valencia, Hart wants big plays, explosive plays. Valencia wants this to be a boring, grounded out, blue-collar type of game.
Hart won the coin toss. They defer. So Valencia will be on offense first. They are in the visiting white and purple. There's Coach Harrington. Black uniforms, the home team, Hart Indians. What a night for football. Great weather in Southern California. 64 degrees, 13% humidity. It's a clear night. Chris McGee, John Jackson, and Courtney Jones. Back to receive, number 14, Edmund Darko, 31, James Berkeley. And kicking off for Hart, senior kicker Rhett Allman. 90% of the time, there is no return. Allman being recruited by BYU and a host of others.
You can feel the electricity in this crowd, Peter, the anticipation. Hart thinks that they have the team to end this streak that Valencia has put together.
And no return. Sean Murphy, 5'11 junior quarterback, rushed for a couple of touchdowns, thrown for four. Young man that really been developing lately. Coach, he's getting better every single week.
And only a junior, and anytime you have a junior at quarterback, the inexperience factor is the one thing you try to overcome. They like the way that Murphy has come on this year. 57% completion percentage, very respectable. The one thing he has to make sure is don't throw the interceptions. If he can keep those down, it's a very explosive offense because they have a tremendous run game.
Spread offense, four wide, single back. And Soli is hit for a one-yard loss. Solid linebackers. It's Griffin Scott with a tackle. You look at the offensive starters. Billy Shipman, who you talked about already, JJ. He's a big-time stud. We'll see him on both sides of the football. Malik Townsend, a young sophomore receiver. Tedrick Thompson, number 7. Junior, a big-time playmaker. We're going to see Murphy. And he dumps it off. And that's our first look at Michael Carter, number 33. This is his first game of the year. They expect to use him a lot tonight. Defensive line, Mitchell Nathan, Wright, Perkins, and Gonzalez. Studley group, Ariaran, Sikoria, and then Timmy White. You're going to see him on both sides of the football, the fastest young man on the team. Third and four for the Vikings. With all kinds of time down the field and through the hands of Michael Carter. And JJ, you saw the speed that Coach Muir talked about this week, and he had his man beat in a step, and he was going to the house with that.
Well, they've added Carter to the lineup. This is the first game that he's been eligible to play, and they go deep because they know that nobody knows how fast he is. He had a step. The ball was a difficult catch because it was over the outside shoulder, but still one that Carter would tell you that he could have caught.
McFeeder's on the punt. And it takes a Valencia bounce. And it keeps rolling. That's inside the 20. To the 19-yard line. And out comes sophomore quarterback Connor Wingenroth. Great athlete. Great feet, JJ.
Ringenroth, they have two quarterbacks here. Ringenroth is one of them. Corey Mays is the other. Mays is more the prototypical quarterback, 6'3", 190 pounds, more of a pocket passer. With Ringenroth in the lineup, they add a little more athleticism. He can run the football. He is mobile. So expect him to do some things to keep him on the move because he can make plays with his arm as well as with his feet.
And keeping it is Ringenroth. A little stutter step and hits the seam, JJ, and he's good for a 15-yard gain.
What a nice run by Ringenroth. Severe option. He's going to read the outside lineman. He keeps the ball himself, and then he tucks it. Now, that move on the defensive end, exceptional. He had the edge. The defensive end knew he had the edge. He did a nice job of cutting back inside to pick up a good gain. This is what Coach Harrington feels that he can get from this young quarterback. They can get him out in space, and he can make big plays.
34-yard line, first and 10. They give to Edwards, and Edwards is hit after about a yard gain. The offensive starters, Lee, Fairchild, Porter, Perkins, and Stafford on the offensive line. Only one senior in that talented group, Trent Irwin, freshman wide receiver, first freshman to ever start on the varsity at Hart. He's a special young talent. Ringenroth dives forward. He's going to be about a yard short of the first down and mark it at the 43-yard line.
Another nice run by Ringenroth. It looks like it was a designed quarterback keep. Give credit to Valencia for staying home at the defensive end spot. That was Shipman. They did not fall for the play action fake. And Ringenroth had to tuck it himself, but he's doing a great job of picking up yards in small spaces. And that's one thing we talk about from running backs a lot, the ability to make people miss in small spaces. Ringenroth is displaying that right now.
Two carries, 22 yards for the sophomore quarterback. This time they give to Edwards, and he has enough for a first down. The defensive line is so solid. Lucas Daggett makes the tackle. Look at the defensive starters. Coach Muir calls it the best defensive line he's ever had. Shipman, Largeman, Ramirez, and Dagan. Gorman, Kelly, and Costley, the linebackers. They went 4-3. Vega, Darko, Lyons, and Thompson. First and 10 at the 45 of Hart. And Edwards is hit by Zach Kelly, number 28.
We're getting a good sample of this defensive line. They are one of the best around, mainly because of what you're seeing right now. They can fly to the football to get off of blocks extremely well. You know, they have to get, if you're Hart, you have to get Dylan Edwards started tonight. You have to make them respect him, but right now that defensive line is not giving up anything in the middle.
Yeah, that front seven is studly. Five returners from a team that went to the semifinals last year. In their last four wins, they've only given up three touchdowns and two shutouts. Keeping himself is Ringenroth. And he gets seven. And it'll be third and one.
Field line one-on-one with Shipman. You have to make sure you control him. That's just staying with it. And then with Ringenroth, he takes takes the ball out to the edge. If you're an offensive lineman, as Austin Lee was in that blocking, if you just stay with the defenders, often your running backs will make a miss.
And Ringenroth goes right up the gut and does not get the first down. Shipman and Ramirez in on the tackle.
What a great job by Shipman coming off the edge. designed him as a defensive end, and you see they try to run the quarterback sneak with some down blocking. They don't block him on the outside, but he's so fast that he comes down and makes the play. That's an instinctive type of play. From a defensive end spot, oftentimes you're told to contain, don't let him outside. But if you feel the offensive line blocking down, you cut that edge off like Shipman did and force a punting situation.
Fourth and short. On comes Rhett Ullman, the punter. And it is a beautiful punt. It's going to roll inside the 10-yard line all the way to the 8. We're going to break, all tied up at 0-0 after a 39-yard punt. Valencia will have the football.
NBA.
Rice battles Houston Wednesday.
Due to time constraints, we now move ahead in our coverage on Prime Ticket.
Clock winding down here towards the end of the first quarter, 0-0.
It's really starting with those defensive line, those big guys up front. They're doing a great job of stopping the run first, which we talked about being one of the keys for Valencia. They needed to get the run game going. They have not. And then when they're forced to pass, that defensive line has shown quickness and agility to be able to run down Murphy.
Short punt, but gets the bounce. Decent field position. The 31 for Hart. Could have been worse. McFeeters. He's got a nice leg. Both teams pretty strong in the kicking game. JJ, who's going to strike first? That's the question tonight. See both teams kind of feeling each other out as well.
Well, no, neither team really wants to take that chance and create a turnover or put their defense in bad position. Right now, the feeling of this game is that both teams feel like their defense, if they force the offense to drive long enough, their defense will ultimately come up with a stop. But it's going to take an explosive play, and it's going to probably have to happen in a passing game because both teams are committed to stopping the run.
Pitch to the right. Throw back, wide open down the field. Wide open and caught by Stauffer. What a play, fumbles. And fallen on by Valencia. It's gonna be a touchback. Valencia usually known for the gimmick trick play. Hart comes up with one. Riley Stauffer gets stripped at about the 10-yard line. We'll take a look at this one more time, JJ, as we go to break. The pitch, the throwback, and look at this hustle by Kelly. The strip, and Valencia has the football.
Since
you're looking at number 28, an early hero in this game, a linebacker, JJ. And what a play, the determination and hustle.
Well-designed play. They toss the sweep, they throw it back to the quarterback, and then they hit Stauffer, who is wide open. And then you see Kelly, watch the hustle, watch his right arm. He comes over the top with that right arm, going after the football. What a heads-up play by Kelly. He does jar the ball loose. A tremendous play and great hustle. This is what big games are all about, when you have to make a play. Look at, he just focused on that right arm, and then he slaps at the ball, knocks it loose. It creates a huge turnover for his team.
And then he got up and was looking to scoop it. Amazing. Great footage right there. Great job with the Fox X-Men. First quarter numbers, that's the only big play we've had so far. It's been a defensive showdown. That was last play of the first quarter. Little play action rolling. Wide open is Thompson. And he has a first down as they gained 13 yards. It's a matter of time before they got Tedrick Thompson the football. leading receiver, junior, 23 catches on the year.
Well-designed play as well, Geeter, with the heart committed to stopping the run. What you have to do is you have to use the run to your advantage. So a play-action fake by Valencia allows Thompson to slip out of the backfield. A nice, easy throw for Murphy and a first down. See, now if you create some of that balance with the passing game, often it'll open up the running game because now the defense doesn't know what to expect. The linebackers have to stay home now. They just can't fly to the football to fly to the first fake because you might fake the handoff and roll out on a boot. So now you have them playing on his defense. It'll make it more difficult to stop this Valencia offense if they balance the attack.
That was Michael Carter running the football. Good for 5 yards. He's a junior. No one could prepare for him because they haven't seen him yet. This is his first game. And they have high hopes for this young man at Valencia. And there's Carter. And you look at him in the space, JJ. Look at his moves. He's across the 50 to the 46-yard line. And that's what Larry Muir told us this week. Nobody's seen him, but just wait till you do.
Nobody has a wider grin on their face than Larry Muir right now because he did not know what to expect from Carter. He looked good in practice. He told us that he looked good in practice. And now you're seeing the quickness, the shifty moves. He's going to add an extra dimension to this offense and make things even more difficult.
First and 10. And Valencia looking like the offensive unit that we've seen the last 2 weeks that put up 65 points, 31 on West Ranch, 34 on Canyon. They're starting to show some signs of that offense.
Well, now they're starting to also pick up some first downs. And if they do that, it'll allow the offensive line to start to beat on and wear down the defensive front of Hart. This Hart defense needs to get off the field. They need to come up with two stops, force a punting situation.
Second down, swing it out to Thompson. And Thompson's to the 32-yard line, and he'll have a first down. They'd love to do that, JJ. A little play action, get Thompson the ball in the flat, give him some space.
And they have to continue to do that. Now you see they swing Thompson across the formation. The linebacker on the opposite side did not account for him coming all the way across the formation, so he sort of got lost in the shuffle. Once again, an easy throw for Murphy.
Loved how Thompson went from the right hand to the left hand and protected the football. Fundamentals. Talk about it every week. First and 10. And Carter hit by Griffin Scott in that Hart defense. Aaron Porter.
The slanting defense that Hart will utilize to try to stop this run defense. That's what they're known for, a 4-3 defense. They like to slant into the gaps. Becomes a little bit of a guessing game with, in terms of the offense by formation of which way you're going to slant. But it's very effective because it allows your defensive linemen to get into the gaps and up the field.
And right over the middle and incomplete. It hit the freshman, J.J. Wilson. It rare that you see two freshmen starting at wide receiver in the ballgame. One for Hart, who we've talked about, Trent Irwin, and here we go with J.J. Wilson.
It was a slant pass. He has it now. Yeah, he just took his eye off of it. A lot of times when you start running that slant across the middle, Geeter, you know that the defenders are coming. You just take your eye off a little bit early. He's a freshman. He's young. He'll learn. It's going to be a tremendous talent before he leaves Valencia.
Third and 9. Possible four down territory. Pass and catch. You saw him on the defense side of the football. He just made a great play. And here he is on offense, Zach Kelly. That's his fifth catch of the year. And a nice throw by Sean Murphy on the money.
Yeah, that's what I was going to talk about. It's a great throw by Murphy. He's able to drop back in the pocket and throw a dart to Kelly. It was like a corner route, but it was a short corner route. And since it was man coverage, Kelly was able to get to the outside. And a nice passing window created by that offensive line. Murphy on target.
Valencia inside the red zone for the first time tonight. First and 10 from the 19. Murphy gives to Soli. Soli breaks free inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. First down and goal, Valencia. Jake Soli, and this is what Michael Carter can do for this football team. He's the guy that has that breakaway speed. Jake Soli is the guy that can get these tough yards inside the red zone, JJ.
Got good blocking up front, as you see, a couple pancake blocks in the middle of that offensive line. And then able to stay on the defensive backs as well. Soli does a nice job running behind that offensive line. Low to the ground, but a very powerful back.
Soli again. And he's to the 2-yard line. Soli's been the starter for the last four games. Two out of the last three, he's been over 100 yards, 112 against Loyola, 128 versus Canyon. Remember, Canyon was undefeated. And Valencia beat them 34-7. They've won four out of five after starting 0-2, JJ. They lost 17-14 to Notre Dame and 14-10 Chaminade. So this is a battle-tested Valencia team. And they are driving inside the 5-yard line. We'll be back.
Welcome back to the Ford CIF Southern Section Game of the Week. We're scoreless here in the second quarter. Radio personality and former USC Trojan, Petros Papadakis hosted a dip symposium competition at West Ranch High on Tuesday. Petros talked to the kids about the importance of staying in shape. You know, a variety of guys got on there and tried to do a dip. Even Petros did. He had 28 dips. But in the end, the winner was Jake. And he's coming up in a second in the video. He had 52 dips. Now, it looks like it was a lot of fun. Chris and JJ, not sure if you guys could get over 52 dips combined. I'm just saying.
Did she say combined?
Oh, gosh.
I was going to say solo. Absolutely not. Not even in my heyday. But I would have given P a run.
I would have given P a run, too.
That's great. Great T-shirt, as usual, by Petros. Friend of ours. And
how many did P do it? 28?
One of the great dudes.
What's the number?
28 for P.
It's impressive. 28 is a good number. See the play selection. Now things starting to balance out for Valencia. And also, coincidentally, they're having a very effective drive.
Play action rolling and keeping it and leaping and in. Number 5, Ryan Gorman. And Gorman, who usually is a backup receiver, gets his first touchdown of the year. Looked like he had the option to maybe throw to Kelly. What an effort.
Yeah, play action fake. And Gorman had Kelly wide open in the flat, but he also saw that he had a seam to run through. He took the safe route, take it himself, and put it in the end zone.
And on the 11th play of the drive, Valencia, after the Schreiber kick, they make it 7-0, JJ. So Hart, with that big play, looks like they were going to score. They fumble, and Valencia takes advantage. And here's one more look at it.
You see it in X-Mo. Nice job by Gorman, finding a nose for the end zone. More importantly, the Valencia offense finally got started. A very consistent drive, 11 plays, 80 yards, ate up over 4 minutes, and it ends on that Gorman 2-yard run. You mentioned this Valencia team being battle-tested. You know, week one, they lost to Notre Dame 17-14 in overtime. And, you know, in that game, Kevin Carrasco, one of the best linebackers in Southern California, one of the best defensive backs in Southern California, had an interception, 42-yard touchdown with 3 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the fourth quarter to get that game into the overtime. And once he got in overtime, he caused a fumble. You know, Kevin Carrasco is one of those underrated guys, go to Notre Dame High School, one of those underrated guys, not quite getting the recruiting attention yet, but will before the end of the season. He had a phenomenal night that night and almost single-handedly beat this Valencia team.
Taken at the 1-yard line is White. Look at the speed. Breaking tackles. and getting all the way out to the 44-yard line, a 43-yard return.
Good field position for the Indians. They needed a nice return, and they got it. That's one thing about kick returners, you know, if these plays often don't get enough attention, but they can change field possession and change momentum so quickly, as Tim White did on that last return. Fastest player on this team, a big play threat. They need to find more ways to get him the football tonight. If Wingenroth is going to find somebody to help him carry the load, I look to number six.
Wingenroth to White. And White to the 50-yard line. He gained six.
I tell you, he was one step from going the distance. A nice safe throw by Wingenroth.
Yeah, everyone went out of the pattern. He just stood around and waited for the football.
White just sort of stood there in the same spot that he aligned, allowed the defenders to drop off and set up a nice screen. More importantly, it creates some short yardage situations. Now it's second and four. Coach Harrington has a lot of options. He can run the ball or throw the ball, knowing they have good down and distance.
Wingenroth almost breaks free as well. He gets a couple, so it'll be third and one.
So he lost his shoe. Remember, Corey Mays is the backup quarterback.
Our coach is telling the players. Tomorrow, Fox Sports West at noon. Don't miss the special Angels press conference as the Angels will announce their new GM. We will welcome Jerry to Anaheim. He's a scout. Colorado for the Red Sox. Former interim GM of the Diamondbacks. What a great job they did getting that young talent to Arizona this year. We saw what a great season they had.
Yeah, takes over for Tony Regans, who also, you know, in my opinion, did a great job as well with the Angel organization. Still around, still will be around the organization. But they want some changes, and, you know, it's interesting. The start of the season, I didn't think that Angel team was going to be in contention on the last week. They were, actually had a chance to win it. And, of course, the team that they lost to ended up being the Texas Rangers, who, of course, are playing tonight for the World Series title.
What a game that was last night, JJ. One of the greatest sporting events I've ever seen. So many clutch moments. Game seven, of course, tonight, as Wingenroth gets the 2 yards. Move the chains. Ball now spotted at the 45-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for Hart. He's got 35 yards rushing tonight.
Now keep in mind, they have not targeted number 16, Trent Irwin, yet. He's the receiver. The top of your screen is to Wingenroth's left. He has yet to throw to him at all tonight.
Look like a late handoff. Dylan Edwards, the ball carrier.
Irwin, the leading receiver on this team, came into tonight with 23 receptions of, you know, 299 yards. Talked about him being a freshman, first freshman to ever start here at Hart. And in order for this offense to keep Valencia guessing, keep them off balance, they're going to have to spread the ball around, and their leading receiver hasn't gotten the ball yet.
23 catches coming into tonight. 4 touchdowns. First freshman to ever start at Hart. Wingenroth airs it out to the sideline. What a catch! And they say incomplete, but the Hart sideline not happy. They're saying that Tim White caught it and then just dropped it. Love to get your take on that, JJ, when we see this replay, a former receiver.
Yeah, it looked to me the same way. It looked like he caught it and then dropped it, but you have to possess the ball, and you have to keep it in your hands long enough. That looks like a catch. It got slapped out of his hands after he got out of bounds. You see the catch there? Foot down, so he's fine. And then now the ball gets slapped out of his hand after he's already stepped out of bounds. That should have been a completion.
That was a great throw and catch. And it will be 3rd and 7 after the hard timeout. Valencia leading.
Like any other day.
Due to time constraints, we now move ahead in our coverage on Prime Ticket.
And McFeeters wisely runs it and taps it and stops it. A 9-yard punt, and it was almost blocked.
Well, the pressure came from the outside. McFeeters felt the pressure, and as he felt the pressure, he didn't hit the ball cleanly. Almost blocked.
But even Corey Mays, the other quarterback, actually.
But even more importantly, see how he sort of short-legged it because he knew the pressure was coming. He sort of short-legged that kick. It actually had some backspin on it. It came back.
Go to Fox Sports West Prep Zone. Greatest thing going. Highlights to your phone. Text Prep Zone 74499. 74499.
We had a chance to go out and sample the Prep Zone ourselves.
Oh, it's fantastic. It's down at the bottom of the stadium here.
Big screen.
Yeah,
on
under
the
bleachers there.
They
fantastic.
Have it on display, and it just shows you how you can watch all the different games at the same time simultaneously. And if you see a big play on another window, you just click on it, get the audio and everything to come in, and you can see that big play.
Four games going on at once. You and I were actually watching the Crespi-Alemany game, which was 21-15.
You were watching the Crespi-Alemany game. I was trying to watch Orange Lutheran against Monterey.
Gotcha, okay. Had to settle that, right? Shipman has him, but he gets loose. Wingenroth gets close to the 50-yard line, out to the 48, J.J., and he's got a 13-yard gain for a first down.
I'll tell you what, I love the guts and the heart that Wingenroth is playing with. You know, coming into tonight, he had 52 rushes, averaging 5.1 yards per rush, and he's just showing his pure athleticism. And then, not typical of a quarterback, at the end of the run, what does he do? He puts his head down, and I know his teammates love that. The ability to escape, and then he's going to put his head in there and show his teammates, look, you know, I'm just like every other running back on this team. I'm a tough guy, too.
That ball's batted down. Incomplete pass. 9 carries for Wingenroth, 40 yards. He's 2 of 7 for 62 yards in the air.
A good defensive pressure again, and this is what Hart can expect the rest of the night. Anytime Valencia gets the sense that they're having some success, the way that Valencia is going to try to combat that success is with extra pressure on Wingenroth and hope that he cannot get the ball out quick enough.
That was A.J. Costley, number 10, linebacker, plays the will. He knocked it down. 2nd and 10. Firing, pass is caught. It should be enough for the first down. That's Riley Stauffer, his 2nd catch of the night.
And once again, Wingenroth able to escape and buy extra time to get this ball off.
Ooh.
A little block in the back, but you know, there's a yardage rule around that, that you can, you know, it's legal. There's a no-clip zone, if you want to call it that. Within a box, I think he was within the box.
It's been a clean first half so far, J.J. Don't jinx it.
Yeah, in contrast to last week where there's so many penalties that we...
23? You
know, it was incredible. I've never seen as many penalties in my life in watching any football game at any level.
Good news is you made it to your flight, you made it to South Bend, and the Trojans won.
What a very good weekend, my friend. Very good.
1st and 10 for Hart. Just under 2 minutes here, 2nd quarter. And there's the freshman, Trent Irwin. He's hit hard. He holds on to the football. That's his first catch of the night.
Okay, I like this play call for several reasons. First of all, every time that Hart goes to a conventional formation where there's two backs in the backfield, you're going to see extra pressure coming from Valencia. They blitz their linebackers with that extra pressure. The counter to that is that Hart decides, look, we're going to call a quick slant. We're going to accept the pressure coming in and take advantage of one-on-one coverage on the outside. So good strategy on both sidelines right now.
Wayne Roth keeps it. And it'll be third down. We'll take another look at this catch. Good concentration. And nice job wrapping up by Darko. But here comes Gorman, who scored that touchdown. And he absolutely lays the wood. Nice job holding on to the football by the freshman.
Yeah, good team speed by Valencia. And more importantly, they got Trent Irwin involved. We talked about it, 23 catches on the year, the leading receiver on this Hart team. And they just find a way to get him the football with under a minute to go in the first half.
You know, on our pregame show, JJ, as we listen to our referees, the timeout.
Timeout was called before the flag.
Danny Vargas and crew doing an exceptional job. You know, the one thing you can tell whether officials are doing a good job is if you don't notice them. If you don't notice them, that means they're doing a good job because they're letting the game flow, let the game come to them. They're going to call it fairly. That's a good sign of good officiating.
Coming up in the Southern California Ford halftime report, Trenton Irwin's wide receiver from Hart. Whoever you talk to, JJ, around town, he's the best they've ever seen at that age. CIF 100th anniversary with Michael Young for the Texas Rangers. First half analysis.
That'll be, to give you an indication of how Trent Irwin's reputation has gotten around during the offseason, I was approached by Billy Miller, who of course played at USC and, you know, played at Westlake and, you know, went on and played, you know, double-digit years from the pros. He was around a long time, and he came up and said, JJ, I got this guy, you know, Trent Irwin. I said, who? He said, who? He's a true freshman. He's great. He's off the charts good. I said, okay, Billy, I'll wait and see. And he ended up being right.
The Pop Warner team last year rolled over everyone. Great quarterback, great skilled players. One of the best Pop Warner teams in the state. Yeah,
incredible. He's playing Pop Warner last year. Wow.
Wingenroth keeps it. And he has the first down.
And now Hart has to hurry up there. First down will stop the clock until the chains get set. But we're at 30 seconds, and they're going to have to take some shots to get in, at least get in field goal range.
Yeah, they say Red Almond can go from 55 yards if need be. Right now, JJ,
it'd be 48 from
48.
From
you're right.
So they're within field goal range, but you know the way that they are moving the ball on this drive, you know, you have to try to see if you could take some shots to try to put seven on the board going into half. It appears like Wingenroth is a little bit more comfortable throwing the football, but I can tell you right now, expect blitz from Valencia. They've done it. They've done it successfully, and every time there's a big play, these next couple plays going into half are considered big plays.
Second and 10.
Here they come.
They're coming. Perfectly tossed to Stauffer. This time he holds on to the football. You love to see a young man learn, JJ. You saw him tuck it in there. What a great play by Riley Stauffer and a good job by Wingenroth to get rid of that football. Noticing the blitz, and they're in the hurry up right now.
They're going to clock it here, stop the clock.
Yep, 24-yard gain. 21 seconds left. And it'll be second and goal.
Now, I love the chess match between the coaches on each sideline. Is, you know, Coach Harrington understands that, you know, the blitz was coming. He anticipated just like we did up here. Sure enough, the blitz did come. He had a good side adjust route called a slant to Stauffer, and one missed tackle. You see him tuck the football away, as you mentioned. One missed tackle, and he's down inside the 10-yard line.
JJ, you talk so much about Irwin and White as a high-profile receiver. Stauffer doing a heck of a job. He's got great hands.
Well, the one thing, though, is the tackle was high. If you go up high at the receiver, they have the strength to shrug you off. Vega was high on his tackle.
Wide open touchdown. Wes Fitzpatrick, that fourth receiver, just a sophomore, and this is a great play, JJ. He lines up in that slot, kind of hides himself, disguises, goes on a little out, a perfect toss. What a job getting his feet down.
It's a half roll. You're going to see Wingenroth, as you mentioned, Geeter, go to the outside and look at the presence for the young sophomore.
Wow.
Knowing exactly where the cone is. Fitzpatrick keeps his feet in bounds, secures the football, and has Hart's first touchdown of the night.
Second touchdown of the year for the sophomore, Wes Fitzpatrick. And what a drive by Hart. Great clock management. They picked up a couple of big first downs on third down conversions. They reset the clock to 17 seconds. Red Allman.
How about the future of Hart football? We've seen Wingenroth, who's only a sophomore. Fitzpatrick, who caught the touchdown pass, sophomore. Trent Irwin, who leads the team in receptions, freshman. Being led by a lot of young talent.
I'm gonna take a look at this touchdown, a couple different angles.
Well, here's the half roll, and when you're the quarterback-receiver relationship, you know, it's all about location on the field. The quarterback is throwing to a spot the receiver's expected to get there. Fitzpatrick knows that that ball is going to be thrown 1 yard deep in the end zone and over the cone, so the only Fitzpatrick could come up with it, otherwise that ball would have fallen incomplete.
Great concentration by the Hart receivers. You saw Irwin on that slant, Stauffer on the previous play, and then Fitzpatrick, just that presence of mind, as you said, to know exactly where the pylon was.
The receivers work on that drill a lot in practice. You know, it's a sideline drill where you run full speed and the coach throws it over to the sideline. You have to dot the eye or keep that foot in. You know, you just sort of dot that eye right before you go out of bounds. That's called dot the eye. You hit your toe on the ground. You only have to have 1 foot in bounds. You have to make sure you keep that 1 foot in bounds while knowing where you're at on the field in relationship to the sideline.
Last year, Valencia on their way to the third straight Foothill title and into the semifinals of the Northern Division. They were down at half to Hart last year. It looks like JJ can hold on for another 17 seconds. We're going to be 7-7 deadlocked. We've seen some great football, some hard-hitting football, just like we expected. And I think in the past, JJ, we'd be shocked at 7-7 with Hart and Valencia. But not tonight, just because of the style that they've been playing this year.
Styles have changed. Both teams really run-oriented. So you take a look at the Foothill standings on where these teams sort of line up and why this game is so important. Valencia 2-0 in league play. Canyon and Hart, West Ranch and Saugus all at 1-1. And then Golden Valley, you know, they're 0-2, struggling a little bit. But three teams out of the Foothill League will make it to the CIF playoffs, an automatic bid. There'll also be one team that will get the at-large wild card team, so to speak. So it's very important to finish in the top three, otherwise you jeopardize yourself of not making the playoff. And both these teams are definitely playoff ready teams.
We'll be going to Courtney Jones in a moment. All tied up 7-7. And it's been the kind of brawl we expected. Neighborhood ball game. Check in with Courtney Jones. Courtney.
Thanks, Chris. Coach Muir, the most exciting play of the game was that big strip by linebacker Zach Kelly. How huge was that turnover in the first half?
That gave us some spark. It gave us a little life. We were really struggling to get a little rhythm going on offense, and it was a great execution by them, but our kids just did a great job of never quitting. They went back and did a great strip back there, and it was a great play by them, but we've got to play much better here in the second half.
You know, aside from that big play, how well is your defense playing in the first half?
They're doing a really good job, and they're doing a really good job against the run. We have to make a couple of adjustments, I think. I think we, on the short passing game, we got to do a better job of kind of tackling and make sure we're getting some secure tackles. Other than that, our kids are playing hard. We just got to make a few adjustments here and there, and we'll be okay.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
And coming up on the forward half side, freshman for Hart, Trent Irwin. There's more to this receiver than what you can see on the field. We're all tied up 7-0, College of the Canyons.
Welcome back. FS West, Halloween coming up on Monday. We are live from College of the Canyons, all tied up 7-7. Let's catch up with Courtney Jones. Courtney.
Thanks, Chris. Coach Harrington, your offense was able to score towards the end of the half, but what more do you want to see from them in the second half?
Well, we got to be a little bit more consistent. Connor Wingenroth did a great job picking up blitzes and getting the ball off, and that was key to that drive, and we made some big plays there. We just need to continue to do that, continue to keep things going on offense, and hopefully play good defense.
This is a rivalry game, but is this the kind of game you expected?
I was hoping it would be this way because, you know, they're a very good team, and I was hoping we were here in this situation at halftime and get the opportunity maybe to pull this out.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, thank you, Coach. And thank you, Courtney.
Thank you very much.
Hart alumni, JJ, currently in the NFL, Kyle Bowler and Matt Moore.
You know what great years they had here at Hart. Of course, Bowler goes on to Cal, Matt Moore to UCLA, and now they are both in the NFL and still playing. And, you know, there was a period of time that Hart had all CIF quarterbacks from 1985 all the way through, you know, starting with Jimmy Bonds, and then it went to, you know, Moore, then Bowler, then Matter, then Norton. All of them were all CIF players, and that's all that was produced here at Hart High School, and they were known for producing great quarterbacks. And so, you know, even though the years have passed, when those guys are considered old veterans in the NFL, it was right here where they started, and we had a chance to see them right here on FS West.
Connor Wingenroth, 154 total yards. He's been able to rush for 42, threw for a touchdown. And they also produced some great volleyball players here. I don't know if you knew that, JJ, in the 90s. Chad Strickland was an All-American in college. Yeah. Cal State Northridge. And actually, Keith Mackin, who's defense coordinator, was a great DN. He also played volleyball. We always got to sneak that in for you, JJ. And JJ, you had mentioned before, everyone who starts playing football in this area, Hart becomes your rival. And these two schools, just 5.1 miles apart. And you had mentioned this, these guys play together in Pop Warner. You drive by one school to get to the other.
And the funny thing is that some of them were on the same Pop Warner team but go to the different high schools, so now they're playing against each other.
You know, West Ranch, one of the new schools, emerging. Canyon, of course. You know, Saugus with a huge win last week over Hart, and then Golden Valley.
Yeah, that win, Saugus beating Hart, is why all those teams have, you know, our 1-1. Of course, Valencia is still on top at 2-0. But it makes it that much more important. And this is a very pivotal second half for both teams. This will go a long way in determining the Foothill champion and could go a long way in determining who is in and who is out of the playoff.
You see the two coaches. That is Coach Harrington. And we saw Larry Muir. What a great job he has done here. 7 years as the head coach, 9 years as an assistant. Went to Alamany High School and walk-on at UCLA. Coach Muir's wife, actually, Pam Walker, is director of basketball operations at UCLA. And when Nikki Caldwell, the coach at UCLA, got the job at LSU, Larry Muir and his wife almost moved.
Yeah. We talked about that on the call with him. He said he's very close to not being here. And of course, that would have been a huge loss for Valencia. From a selfish standpoint, they would have lost a very, very good coach that has really built this program up. Remember, it was not long ago where Valencia was looking up at Hart and wanting to be like Hart and had no chance of being like Hart. And now that the mindset has changed, now Hart is down looking up at Valencia, which for those that grew up in this area, it's even shocking that you ever have, you'd ever be able to make that statement.
It's so great to see this matchup. Of course, Mike Harrington, a legend in Southern California, 6 CIF championships, 23 years at Hart. His brothers coaching over at Alamany, the Harrington family. just goes with football in this area. Now Larry Muir has Valencia emerging as one of the top teams in the Northern Division in CIF. Three trips to the semifinals. And the expected smash mouth football with some big hits, and you're seeing it tonight. It's funny, you talk to both coaches, they know each other real well, these two schools. They run the same system. They almost know what the other one's gonna do before it happens.
You know, just another sign of how Valencia has been so dominant as of late, you know, in this area. You know, they haven't lost a league game, Geeter, since until 2008. And that last loss was to Saugus on November 7th, 2008. So it's been that long since they have lost a game in league, which is a phenomenal record. Undefeated last year, undefeated the year before, and 4-1 in 2008.
Incomplete pass, and I'm going to update you on a couple of scores in that Pac-5, because we do have a big matchup next week on the Game of the Week. Servite and Modern Day. Servite is 14-14 with St. John Bosco.
St. John Bosco, of course, pulled off a big victory last week against Modern Day.
And J.J. Mission Viejo, 23-0 over the number two team in the Pac-5, San Clemente.
Yeah, San Clemente was, a lot of people 8-0. Predicted an upset. They were undefeated, and they thought that San Clemente was going to go in there and beat Mission Viejo. Of course, it's not looking too good for them right now.
Wingenroth. And incomplete. Trying to run that little slip screen, it seemed like, to White, get their playmaker the football.
So far, good start to the second half by this Valencia defense. Hart trying to take advantage of their aggression, and anytime you feel a team is being aggressive or you expect blitzes, as we've seen in the first half from Valencia, you try to throw those screens to try to catch them off balance and, you know, use their aggression against them. That time, Valencia shows very nice discipline on defense, matching up with their players, understanding that you do your responsibility, and the whole defensive concept works.
Third and 10. Looking for the freshman down the field and almost intercepted. Great coverage by Edmund Darko, number 14. And he's a young man with speed as well, one of the fastest guys on the team.
Yeah, one of the fastest players, and he was stride for stride with Irwin. Comes a foot race, and Darko actually should have intercepted that ball. Really good coverage.
Great coverage.
Ooh, it would have been his first interception of the season also.
He would have had a little room too. Almost blocked. You mentioned that spin, the football comes back. Earlier in the broadcast, we talked about punts that come back, JJ, almost blocked. And it's going to be great field position after a 24-yard punt, but almost blocked. Look at this, Jay.
Yeah, well, what happens is the punter, when they start to feel the pressure, and trust me, they feel the pressure when it comes, oftentimes they short-leg it a little bit, and that, you know, takes the spin, the proper spin off the ball to get that favorable bounce. The good field position for the Vikings as they get their first possession on the Hart side of the 50.
Fake to Carter, go to Townsend. Excuse me, that's a freshman, J.J. Wilson. And J.J. Wilson picks up 12.
But both coaches offensively getting the sense that the defense for the opposite side is playing aggressive, so you're going to see a lot of plays like this. You know, the fake the screen one way, come back the other way. You're just trying to take advantage of the speed and aggression of the defense and use it against them.
Ball's marked at the 32-yard line. It's going to be first and 10 for Valencia. Hart three and out on their first drive. Swings it out to Carter. And Carter dancing. and lunging forward. Gets about a yard.
I think that was Ararian in coverage, and what a great job he did out on the edge against Carter. You know, Carter's one of those speed players that if you get the ball to him in open space, you know, it's big time trouble. And a lot of defensive coordinators, their heart rate really starts picking up when he catches the ball in that open space. Ararian did a great job of getting out, and he didn't make the tackle, but he wrapped him up enough to allow the pursuit to catch up.
Harrington and Matkin love Anthony Ararian, senior linebacker. Flies to the football. Carter. And Carter for a loss. It looks like 70 Perkins and 43 Sikoria.
Sikoria, the middle linebacker, he's in the middle of that defense. And he's one of those guys that will hit you. 6'1", 210 pounds. You know, very physical, and you saw it on that play. You know, linebackers like Sikoria, they just like to run through people. It's a great technique if you're playing linebackers. You want to run through the ball carrier, not just go and wrap him up. You want to run through him, and that's what you saw in that last play by Sikoria.
Started at defensive end last year, now leads the team with tackles. 71 coming into the ball game. Once again, defense playing big. That time it's Griffin Scott. All three linebackers playing big on this drive.
Ararian, then Sikoria, then Scott. You know, linebackers are so important to your play, and it's all about assignment defense. You know, they just try to slip Carter out of the backfield, and Scott says, no, that's my man. I have him. Don't worry about it. And then the emotion is a great sign as well, because his heart defense is playing inspired. A lot of people thought if they were on the field a long time tonight, it would be a long night because of the strength and the physicality of this Valencia offensive line.
Kick into the end zone, so Hart will take over on the 20-yard line. We're going to break in the Foothill League from College of the Canyons, all tied up at 7.
Due to time constraints, we now move ahead in our coverage on Prime Ticket.
The Ford CIF Southern Section Game of the Week is brought to you by your Southern California Ford dealers. Visit us today and trade up to Ford. The pumpkin patch, Halloween around the corner. Here on Fox Sports West, all tied up 7-7, and it has been a defensive battle and a hard-hitting affair here at College of the Canyons. JJ, as you look at the stats after three quarters.
Well, as the game is even, so are the stats. Relatively even, Hart just a little bit of an edge in terms of yardage. You know, 2 turnovers to 1, time of possession even as well. So, you know, just as we thought we were going to get a great game. You know, we're on drive up here, and we're getting exactly that, and it's going to take another quarter, the last quarter, to finish it.
Third and short. Wingenroth keeps it himself. He has the first down, and Moore stays on his feet, and he's to the 35-yard line of Valencia, and a late flag comes in.
And this is going to be a costly penalty. After a great run by Wingenroth, Hart is going to get hit for a late hit, unsportsmanlike conduct. It's going to cost him 15 yards. That's a personal foul.
Did you see it?
I did see it. It was after the play, well after the play. You know, take a look at it.
Dead ball, personal foul, 52, offense, 15-yard penalty. Play resulted in the first down, 1 for Black.
Okay, now what's going to happen is after the play is over, just to the left of your screen, you won't be able to see it on that shot. The number 52, James Fairchild, the three-year starter, you know, leader on this offensive line. He just cleaned off one of the defensive backs after the play was over, after Wingenroth was on the ground, and he hit the defensive back, and that drew the penalty flag.
Ball's now at the 50. first and 10. Underneath, Irwin. And the freshman has another catch.
A well-designed play. They go to a trips look to the left side, and the inside receivers clear through the middle. You're going to watch the inside receivers just go streaks, and then Irwin come under those streaks with a slant, and he's wide open underneath the coverage, and then the run after catch. Takes a good hit at the end of the play. He was able to hold on to the football, but a well-designed play. Very close to another turnover. Well-designed play, though, by Coach Harrington.
And they got those 15 yards back. It'll be first and 10 from the 34-yard line. Wingenroth, and he gets five, and there's a flag.
All right, they're going to get John Perkins, number 70, for holding. So Hart ends up being their own worst enemy on this drive. Holding is a 10-yard penalty.
Holding on the offense, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay first down.
So okay. JJ, almost a flawless game until recently, and now some penalties really costing the Hart Indians.
So they ruled that the hold was a yard in the backfield, so that becomes, with the 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, becomes an 11-yard penalty.
And it'll be first and 21 now, ball 45. Wingenroth, he might just go, and he does, and he's got space. And he's got a first down.
And there's going to be a penalty at the end of this play for a face mask.
Wingenroth, the sophomore quarterback, goes 26 yards, and it looks like they're going to tack on more.
I'll tell you, he is a special talent in terms of running the football. He's only a sophomore, so he's only going to get better, understand the system. One of the things that Coach Harrington told us. There's the face mask call. One of the things that Coach Harrington told us, the difference between this Hart offense and some of the great Hart offenses of the past, is that the knowledge of the quarterback, because Wingenroth is youthful, he just doesn't understand all the things that go into running this offense. But he has the natural talent
and
ability.
Foul, face mask on the defense. Half the distance to the goal line, first down.
And I don't know, yeah, he's going to get hit for a face mask penalty, but I don't even think he grabbed him by the face mask. He hit him in the helmet and grabbed him. It looked like up by the upper shoulder pad. I don't know. It looked like a face mask when it was at full speed from where we were watching it up here. In any event, first down.
First and goal. And Dylan Edwards, touchdown from 9 yards out, and Hart leads. Credit the defense, stopping them on fourth and inches. And I can guarantee you, Dylan Edwards' great-grandfather, who we saw moments ago with Courtney Jones, is smiling now.
A handoff and a cutback. Edwards did a nice job of cutting back against the flow of the defense. But oftentimes, Geeter, the way the quarterback turns and hands the football off, the defense flows to that side. It's a running back's option on.
Play remains first down.
It's a running back's option of where to hit the hole, whether to cut it back or not. Edwards make the right decision on that play, cutting back against the grain where there was nobody to stop.
5-yard penalty now becomes a 25-yard extra point, and possibly a big one. And that is no good.
But there's a penalty flag. It's going to be running into the kicker.
Oh, that is a costly one. No foul. Ball was tipped. Referee is talking and making the call. They've done a great job tonight.
No foul. The ball was tipped.
Yeah, and that's a great job of working together, because as you take a look at the scoring drive, 7 plays, 57 yards, and Edwards takes it in from 9 yards away. But a great job by the officials working together, because the penalty flag was thrown by the white hat, who is in back. They then confirmed that the ball was tipped, and if the ball tipped, you are allowed to run into the kicker. There is no penalty flag, and there's the touchdown by Edwards.
Edwards has really been the spark offensively, along with Connor Wingenroth, the sophomore quarterback. That 26-yard run after the penalty was huge.
But now that missed opportunity at an extra point, the breathes new life into this Valencia Viking team. You see, now they're going to say that the ball is tipped. You know, right there, they're going to say the ball was tipped, and then you can, if you block it, you can run to the kicker. It's only if you do not block it that you cannot.
Mike Harrington, head coach at Hart's brother over at Alamany. Dean victorious over Crespi, 30-28 in the Sierra League battle. Everyone watching that on Prep Zone tonight, FoxSportsWest.com. And last update I had on the Servite game is 28-27 Servite over Bosco. It's a great game.
Servite took the lead.
Okay. Servite took the lead. JJ, we got a great one here at College of the Canyons, 13-7, just over 10 minutes left. There will be no return. Tomorrow, Fox Sports West at noon. Don't miss the special Angels press conference at Angels, announcing new Angels general manager, DePoto, Jerry. Resume speaks for itself. He's a scout for the Red Sox, head of scouting for Colorado in 05, he's interim GM, the Diamondbacks. He comes over from Arizona.
And he will be excited to work with this organization. First class organization. You know, Artie Moreno committed to winning, and that's, you know, half the battle of being a good general manager is you have to have the owner committed to winning, and there's no question that Artie Moreno will do whatever is possible to bring a winner to the Los Angeles Angels in the Anaheim area.
That's noon Pacific. Incomplete pass as they look for Malik Townsend, the sophomore. And it'll be second and 10.
Okay, now if you're Valencia, don't get in desperation mode. There's still 10 minutes to go. Run your offense, execute.
Soli has nowhere to go. The defensive line on that right side, Casey Wright, Mitchell Nathan, Griffin Scott, the linebacker, making it 3rd and 8. Play action rolling. Murphy. And Murphy has run out of bounds. And that'll be 4th down. Sikoria pushes him out, and punt unit comes on.
I tell you, this hard defense just continues to impress. Remember, this is a Valencia offense that was just rolling up points on people before the game started.
31 against West Ranch, 34 last week against Canyon. 65 total in 2 weeks. Really starting to hit their stride offensively. Looks like a short punt. It gets a nice Valencia bounce. Not as nice as it looked like it might have been, but Hart will take over on the 40-yard line. Saturday on the FX College Game of the Week, Charles Davis and Gus Johnson will be in College Station. It's College Station, Texas, where the Missouri Tigers will take on the 16th-ranked Texas A&M Aggies. The latest meeting between two Big 12 rivals. The FX College Football Game of the Week this Saturday, noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, high def only on FX. We're going to get a dose of Dylan Edwards, I can imagine. Eat some clock. All the pressure right now on that Valencia defense. come up with a stop or a turnover.
And it's the first time tonight that this defense has really been under pressure to come up with a stop immediately. You know, good field position for Valencia, so that's one problem. But the other problem is there's 9 minutes on the clock, and if they allow Valencia to run too much time off the clock, it'll only give their offense one opportunity to score.
Wing and Roth.
How about that from the sophomore? That last surge is going to get him really close to the first down.
Looks like he's going to be just short. I thought that second surge got in there, but I think the whistle blew, actually. Hart crowd not liking it.
Yeah.
It'll be third down. He's been the biggest issue for this Valencia defense, his ability to run the football.
And although the Hart crowd is not happy with him not getting the first down, that might be the best thing for them. Because now with third and one, if you do get the first down, you're going to knock off another minute on the clock and make the time, the window for the Valencia offense to score even smaller.
Wingenroth now with 88 yards rushing. As he gets a first down, you make a great point, JJ. That clock on the side of the Hart Indians.
See, now they're going to run off another 25 to 30 seconds for this play as well. And so the game is just getting shorter for the Valencia Vikings. They're going to have to start using their timeout, but they're going to have to come up with a stop here. They can ill afford to allow Hart to get in a short yardage situation again, because then you can't use your timeout.
Dylan Edwards.
Now tough choice here.
Picks up four.
He's going to get 4 yards. They're going to save their timeouts. It's a good decision, I think, right here not to use them. Three timeouts left for both teams. Hart obviously in no hurry. Larry Muir's going to have a decision to make after this play, but he knows his defense has to. You can't let them have third and three or less. A second and five now. You need a big stop here. If Hart gets down to a third down and two, well, then it becomes difficult to burn a timeout, because if they pick up another first down, you've just wasted it. No, and in an attempt to try to run as much clock as possible, Hart gets called for delay of game, and now that will stop the clock and make it a long yardage situation. And there's the quarterback, Sean Murphy.
Murphy hoping to stay warm a little bit.
Hoping to get another opportunity. But the best defense for Murphy is to have him on the sideline and on the bike.
Head ball, false start. Offense, 5 yard penalty. Play remains second down.
Did you feel like the Valencia defense have been in this position before, and it's Wingenroth that has made something happen. So they got to be careful in watching him.
Well, that big run he had on the last drive where they had the football for 26 yards and a first down is what really broke the back of Valencia on that drive and led to this 6-point lead. Defense ill afford to have that happen again, to the point where in this second and long situation, you might think about keeping a spy on Wingenroth, because he has been the most dangerous weapon for them in the second half.
Can he get away? No, not this time. That defensive line comes up big. Shipman and then Dagen.
And Larry Muir is going to save his timeouts, not use one here. The clock will continue to run because he was tackled inbounds. Another coverage sack, and you know, just can't do that against this defense. This defense is way too fast. This defensive line is the strength of the defense. So as a quarterback, you cannot hold on to the football too long, or else it's going to lead to trouble.
Third and a long way, 23. First down marker at the 34-yard line. Valencia. There's Wingenroth. They don't wrap him up. He gets outside. But then they make the tackle. And out comes Rhett Allman, number 26. Remember, Valencia's brought pressure a couple of different times, JJ. They came close to blocking one. You definitely don't want to get a roughing the punter call here.
Okay, now Coach Harrington, with the clock running, most likely will let the clock run all the way down and possibly even take the five-yard penalty. And let Allman, who has a great leg, let him kick because they're at the 47-yard line, which is why that last run by Wingenroth was so important. Because with Allman's leg, he can still pin them down inside the 20.
Ooh, calls for the fair catch. He actually had some room. It's Malik Townsend, the sophomore. 36-yard punt by Allman. 91 yards away. Valencia will have the ball.
Paying with your smartphone instead of cash. That's a step forward. With Chase QuickPay, you can send money directly to anyone's checking account.
I guess he's a kicker.
Again, again!
No, no, you don't.
Take a step forward and chase what matters.
There's no other place in the country where you can climb, bike, board, and surf all in the same day. That's why we put so much all in the same truck. Ram 1500. Guts, glory, Ram.
Cheer tomorrow's stars today at the CIF Southern Section Ford Basketball Championships, presented by Farmers. 20 boys and girls high school basketball games coming to the Anaheim Convention Center, February 28th through March 3rd, with adult tickets starting at just $13, kids and students $5. It's your chance to see future stars up close and personal. The CIF Southern Section Ford Basketball Championships, presented by Farmers. February 28th through March 3rd at the Anaheim Convention Center.
Welcome back to the Ford CIF Southern Section High School Football Game of the Week. 13-7 Hart over Valencia. We have a great football game right here, and it's getting real interesting. And next week, the Game of the Week is on Friday. Servite versus Modern Day. The rivalry from the Old Angeles League will take place at Angel Stadium. Spotlight starting at 7 p.m. That'll be the National High School Football Game of the Week. And I believe Servite leading 35-27. Over St. John Bosco. They were down in the fourth, 27-21. We'll try to update you on that one.
Well, they had their scares. It'll be interesting to talk to Troy Thomas about what he feels about his team after St. John Bosco played them so tough. Not to be not a surprise maybe around the Southland, but not a surprise to people who really know that Trinity League. St. John Bosco is very tough this year.
Murphy being chased out of the pocket, and that ball's loose, and there's no whistle. And now it's incomplete.
That's a good call. Murphy trying to buy as much time as possible, trying to allow his receivers to uncover. You have to be impressed by the way that Hart has played defense tonight. The defensive line is getting after the quarterback, but the coverage in the secondary has been spectacular.
All night.
He's very fortunate that that was a forward pass. He did have his arm going forward. This is a good call. Most importantly, he avoids a sack.
Murphy looking over the middle, and it's caught by Zach Kelly. The linebacker has come up with two big catches tonight. And the strip at the end of that first quarter to save a hard touchdown.
Peter, how about this grab, though? In traffic, three defenders around him, and Kelly still comes up with it. Murphy waits. He looks at him a long time, which is going to draw a lot of attention, but that is great concentration by Kelly.
Good job by the offensive line. And there is no running on the Hart D.
Well, they can feel it. Remember that this Hart team has a lot of frustration going against Valencia.
Valencia.
JJ, put your coach's hat on. 3:52 left. The ball is at the 19 and a half yard line.
And I think
just before the 20.
And I think in this case, they have to go back to the plays that have been working. And the one thing that has worked is getting Tedrick Thomas out into the flat. You have to throw the ball here. You can't take a chance on running because you have to anticipate that Hardy's going to bring pressure from their linebackers.
So you're saying there's no question about it. You go for it right here. With two timeouts left, 3:53.
Yeah, you have to go for it. I don't think you can afford to give the ball back to Hart, knowing that you have two timeouts. You have to stop. You have two timeouts. You will be able to stop them, stop the clock a couple times. But if you do get the ball back, which you may not, if you do get the ball back, it'll probably be with less than 2 minutes, and it'll be deep in your own territory after a punt.
Fourth and two. One for one on fourth. One for two, excuse me. Oh, they go play action. They do exactly what you said. They go to Thompson in the flat.
And then Thompson does a great job of understanding the situation and getting out of bounds.
You watched film this week. They ran that on the first play of the game last week against Canyon.
Thompson lines up in a wing to the right side. You see him coming across the screen and into the flat. Murphy waits for him to uncover, delivers the ball to him, and then right here is maybe the decision of the game by Thompson. Understanding the situation and getting out of bounds to stop the clock.
Ooh, what a play, closing.
And that's Wingenroth.
That is Wingenroth, the quarterback.
The coach told us during the week that he is a great athlete. If he wasn't starting at quarterback, and he hasn't played quarterback full-time this year, when he is not a quarterback, he goes out to receiver. And then now in a pressure situation where you need to come with the stop, they move the young sophomore to cornerback.
Second and 10. Murphy's going to run, and he's looking to get out of bounds. He can't make it. He's caught from behind by Griffin Scott.
One thing Sean Murphy has to remember is that there's still over 3 minutes left on the clock. This is not, I mean, it's a hurry-up situation. You have to play with some urgency, but you don't have to get desperate. This is not a throw-it-up-for-grabs type of situation. Just concentrate on getting first downs.
They need one now, third and four. Quick out, and it's a low throw. He was looking for Zach Kelly in another fourth down situation for Valencia.
I'll tell you, if you're Larry Muir, and I would have done it on third down, but you have to go with a double move here. You know, on third down would have been ideal. Fourth down, probably not the opportune time. I look for another pass, another half roll, and get one of the running backs in the flat. I don't think you can go back to Thompson again because Hart will be waiting for him this time.
Hart trying to get themselves back in the Foothill League picture.
I look for Kelly, number 28, who's to the left.
Murphy has time. He's going to roll. He throws it up, and it's caught by J.J. Wilson, a freshman.
J.J. Wilson says, I'm the second freshman in this game you have to pay attention
remember
to.
Remember me, too. All kinds of time.
Great blocking by the offensive line. And Murphy stayed poised and under control, waiting for somebody to uncover. And then he goes to the freshman.
Wow.
And what a great catch and concentration.
Big time play. Ball at the 49-yard line of Valencia. First and 10. 2:44 and counting. Murphy going deep, and he's held. And a flag. It'll be pass interference. JJ, I'm going to say that's a smart play. When you're beat, and I think you mentioned this a couple weeks ago on the broadcast, you can't let that guy get behind you, especially in this kind of situation.
Yeah, well, Valencia wanted to take a shot down the field. It was Porter in coverage, and he was beat by a step. And when Porter realized that Murphy was coming to his receiver, he held him by the jersey, which was the correct thing to do. Plenty of time to throw. Again, a good pocket to throw, and right there you see the pull of the jersey.
Defensive pass interference. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
2:37. Plenty of time. Again, Murphy does not have to go for the home run. First downs are what you need.
10th play of the drive. Nowhere to go. 2-yard loss. Hard D line. Corey Mays, the other quarterback. Quarterbacks are playing D now for Hart.
Exactly. The two quarterbacks, as Corey Mays is on the edge trying to bring some pressure, add some speed to that defense as he's lined up at defensive end and trying to come around the outside to get pressure on Murphy.
To the corner, to Thompson. Caught at the 5-yard line. Sean Murphy bought himself some time. And a perfect throw and catch. Tedrick Thompson, their leading receiver, 32 yards to the 5.
Are you kidding me? Thompson runs a post from the slot position on the opposite side of the field, and what a great catch. Plenty of time, great blocking by the offensive line, gives Murphy an opportunity to get the ball to him, and the biggest play of the game for the Vikings.
Now, JJ here on the 5, you have to score a touchdown. Are you gonna run the football? Yes. They haven't been able to do that too successfully as Soli goes to the 4-yard line. And Murphy runs over to Coach Larry Muir to get the call, and the clock will be stopped. Timeout, Hart. Hart now thinking, in case they score, we got to get the ball back.
They have to make sure they leave themselves enough time. Valencia will definitely have 4 plays from this area of the field to score. The problem for Larry Muir and company is the running game has been extinct. They have not been able to run the football the entire night, and this is the point of the field where you want to be able to run it. All of this being set up by a phenomenal throw by Murphy to Tedrick Thompson, and it doesn't get any better than that.
Great throw, great catch, and the drama is at an all-time high here at College of the Canyons. These two schools, rivals, separated by 5 miles. All the kids know each other. Hart hasn't beaten Valencia since 2006. They tied in 2007. Hart is the boss in these parts for years. 20 Foothill League titles, 8 CIF championships. Valencia has owned the Foothill League, winning the title the last 3 years.
Now, I don't know what play call, if you're Larry Muir, that you call here. I just know that the ball has to get in Tedrick Thompson's hands, number 7.
Murphy, he listens to you, JJ. Touchdown, Valencia. The play action and over the top to Tedrick Thompson from 4 yards out. And how big is that missed extra point after the penalty? Now it's 13-13. Valencia can take the lead. Minute and 36 left. That ended up being a real smart timeout by Mike Harrington.
A great play call and a great job of deception by Thompson as he came off the line half speed, almost indicating that he was going to block. A nice play action fake allowed him to uncover. The extra point gives Valencia the lead, and Larry Muir breathes a sigh of relief.
14-13. Minute 36 left. Hart needs a field goal to win. They got a great kicker in Red Allman.
Yeah, don't forget
that. He can make
that.
It from 55 yards, JJ. I'll tell you what you don't want to do if you're Valencia. Kick to Tim White.
Murphy, nice job of selling the run. You see how far he stuck the ball in to Soli. You have to respect Soli. And I told you before the play, you have to respect Thompson.
You also said, I don't know what play call you have. Get the ball to Tedrick Thompson. Coach Larry Muir. He knows this game is far from over. Dangerous. White at the eight. And White stays on his feet all the way to the 43-yard line. Tim White. Well, they're lucky he didn't go for six right there.
They are lucky. The last person that you want to have the ball in that situation is White. You called it, Geter. I mean, you know that Tim White is the most dangerous player that Hart has, and they kick the ball to him and allow him a free run on a kickoff return. His speed gets to the corner, and you're exactly right. That's the last man to beat, and you're lucky he did not take that one the distance. Good field position for the Hart Indians. Excitement again in a Hart game.
Wingenroth, every time we come out here, JJ, it's a nail biter, and this is when that matchup that both coaches talked about, that you and I talked about during the week, that defensive line for Valencia, the best they've ever had, up against that Hart offensive line that is young but so talented. They're bringing him. Gets rid of it. And out of bounds. So impressed by the sophomore quarterback, Connor Wingenroth, and the junior quarterback, Sean Murphy, for Valencia. Both these guys are doing a great job. They're not panicking, as you've been talking about all game, really keeping their poise in pressure situations.
Well, the trust that Coach Harrington has in Wingenroth really shows you how far the sophomore has come really in this game. You know, we were told during the week that Wingenroth's more athletic and maybe Corey Mays more of the pocket passer. Well, in this situation of two-minute offense, you'd think the pocket passer would be the guy to go to. They're choosing to stay with Wingenroth.
Third down, catch, the freshman, Trent Irwin, gets his feet down, and he has five catches tonight. That's a Hart first down. There's 54 seconds left. And partner, they're creeping into range for Rhett Almond.
An impressive throw by Wingenroth, and how much has he grown in just one football game? Stands in the pocket. Remember early in the game, he's trying to pull that ball down and run with it. He was getting sacked. Now he just stays in the pocket, delivers a strike to the freshman.
Be careful of Wingenroth running the football now. They're bringing guys again. They got the option. And he's at the 40-yard line. Remember, we showed you earlier when we were last here in 2007, Hart beat Canyon in the wind and rain on a last-second field goal 44 yards out by a young man named Johnny MacArthur.
Timeout, Hart.
Hart tries to catch Valencia off balance with a little option play. Wingenroth was keeping it all the way and hoping to pick up positive yardage and even possibly get out of the bounds. Since Hart had two timeouts, you could take a chance with a run play like that.
We're going to show this one more time. What an amazing game, 2007. Canyon, the defending state champions at home, taking on Hart. Hart would get back in the ball game. And then an interception with 31 seconds. You think it's going to end in a tie, but Canyon throws deep. Johnny MacArthur, he's now a golfer at Pepperdine with an interception. They run a draw play to Delano Howell. And look at the awareness, JJ. He's going to glance at the clock, go 73 yards, and get out of bounds. Johnny MacArthur would line up for the first field goal of his life. On the road for the win, and he got it, 44 yards.
An incredible feeling for Coach Harrington and his Hart team. They would love to walk off the field with the same feeling tonight.
Kept alive! White's gonna break free! White's gonna score! Another miracle in the Foothill League. Unbelievable. All the pressure on Wingenroth. He tosses it up. It's tipped. And Tim White with a touchdown.
A lot of credit has to go to both coaches, Geeter. When the pressure is on, they get the ball to their playmakers. And what an outstanding play by White. The presence of mind to tip the ball to himself. And then he takes it the distance. Just an incredible, incredible fourth quarter.
You think Hart's obviously going to go for two here. Leading 19 to 14, Tim White, you talked about him in the open, the senior receiver and the freshman receiver, Trent Irwin, how they were the playmakers. And watch this, JJ, you talked about him tipping it to himself.
He just batted the ball in the air, soft hands, and tipped it to himself. What presence. That is not something you teach in practice. That's not something you work on. That is just a playmaker making a play. And that was intentional to bring that ball back to himself. What an outstanding job by Tim White. Wow.
That ball thrown behind. It could have been maybe intercepted as well. Incredible. 36 seconds left.
And actually good coverage. Barry Lyons was in coverage. He's the senior safety, and he had good coverage.
Tim White started it all off with that big return on the kickoff. Play action. Incomplete. Most likely, JJ, with Rhett Allman kicking, Valencia is going to be on the 20, and they're going to have to go 80 yards in 36 seconds.
That Hart scoring drive covered 57 yards in five plays. It only took a minute. It all started with the Tim Wright kickoff return that put them in great field position, and then as Hart started to get close to field goal range, you felt Valencia felt they had to add more pressure to the quarterback, Wingenroth, being a sophomore, inexperienced, of course, in this type of a situation, and that ended up burning them because they were in man-to-man coverage, and White was the better man on that last play.
Tim White.
I mean, we've seen emotion go from one side of the field to the other side of the field almost instantly. There was moments ago that the Valencia fans and the cheerleaders and the players were celebrating, and then now the momentum clearly back on the side of the Hart Indians.
And JJ, you see weapons all the time in kickers. Loftus last year for Servite, Alex Ball over at Westlake, Rhett Allman tonight. Guys that kick it into the end zone.
A huge advantage knowing that Allman is going to put this ball into the end zone and there will not be a return. Actually, he kicked it short. There will be a return.
And now a kicked ball. And Hart's going to fall on it and win the ball game. Rhett Allman, 90% of the time, kicks it out of the end zone. That time, he doesn't, and it pays off.
Well, a short kick, and we thought this was going to be an opportunity for Valencia. Darko just misplayed it. And if you're a kick returner, the one thing you have to make sure when you catch kickoffs is you have to sort of give with the ball. It's like soft hands. You have to let the ball sort of come to you. You saw Darko never got his hands on the ball. It looked like it even appeared to hit his face mask and bounce off.
Hart just got themselves back in the Foothill League race as number 8 in the Northern CIF division takes down number 4, a team they hadn't beaten since 2006, and the celebration is on homecoming night at Hart High School from College of the Canyons. What a battle. Both teams playing as hard as they could. Both defenses coming up huge and playing hard all night. Two young quarterbacks, and that young man right there, Tedrick Thompson, what a night he's had. They thought it was the go-ahead and winning touchdown, but that would not be the case. Wingenroth throws, Timmy White tips it, catches it, and he's gone. Hart wins. An amazing night here in the Foothill League. Look at the speed. He's the fastest man on the team, a 4.440. Untouched into the end zone. Great respect for both programs. As Larry Muir, the great coach for Valencia, has said many times, we've tried to emulate Hart. They are the program that everyone wants to be like. And Hart, who's had a rough couple of years, they are back. And their fans know it. Valencia will go to 2-1 in the Foothill League, as will the Hart Indians. And you saw one side of it as Valencia gathered around Larry Muir, a teachable moment for the coach, and how this team will bounce back. But tonight belongs to Mike Harrington, as it has so many nights over the last 23 years. He's had a lot of great victories. Where this one ranks, I don't know. We'll see him afterwards on the set. The post-game show will be a great one. For John Jackson, Courtney Jones, I'm Chris McGee. 19-14, the final. Join us next week, 7:30 p.m., Servite, Modern Day. Stay tuned next. We'll be down on the field for the High School Spotlight post-game show.